Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name's Rachel and this is Stitched Up. So today's Easter Sunday. I hope that you're all having a fantastic day. The weather here at the minute is just beautiful. And we never get this kind of weather at the bank holidays in the UK, so I don't know what's going on, but it's just gorgeous. So I've been really busy today. I have been trying to get on top of some housework, so I've gutted my downstairs today, so it's all clean and tidy, which is just lovely. Which is why my hair is a little bit messy, because I went for a run this morning. I ran 9 miles first thing this morning before it got super hot. So yeah, jumped in the shower after that, and then I've had my hair tied up while I've been doing the chores in the house. Anyway, the reason I'm here with you today is I thought I would share with you some patterns that I've recently purchased. In the UK at the minute, McCalls patterns are on sale. It's their early spring collection that's out at the minute. I think the late spring will probably be due out fairly soon, and I always take advantage of the sales when they're 50% off, because we just don't get the kinds of bargains that you guys over in the States do. We never get patterns down at $1.99 a pattern, unless you can pick them up second hand. So the most we get is 50% off, which makes them around about £4, which is probably about $6, something like that. So, you know, it's there, and yeah, I have purchased, I think, 5 or 6 patterns that I thought I would show you, and one of them I've already made up into a dress that I'm going to be wearing later today. So before I show you my patterns, let me first start by showing, I've got hair in my mouth, oh. Let me first start by telling you what I'm wearing. I'm wearing the cocoon dress today. I will put some better pictures in of me wearing it so you can have a little look. But this is, I'm not sure who made this pattern actually. It was very popular probably a year or two ago now. I'm not sure if it was a simple sew one that was out with a magazine a couple of years back, and everybody on social media, especially lots of beginner sewers, were going mad for this pattern. And I can understand why. It's fairly simple. It's you know, a pull on over your head dress for woven fabrics. There's no fastenings or closures at all. It's obviously got a little v-neck with a facing inside, short cap sleeves as you can see, and it's got a bit of a cocoon shape as well, and comes to sort of just above the knee, except mine's a little bit short actually. I made it in this really lovely sea salt fabric. I've just come a bit closer so you can have a look. This is a cotton, I think it's a cotton voile, but it's got like a bit of a crepe texture to it, so I'm not sure whether it's a cotton crepe. But yeah, it's one that I picked up from the sea salt store in Padstow in Cornwall a couple of years back when I was on holiday there. I got 3 meters of it. I think it was about £25, something like that. I'm not quite sure, but anyway, yeah, it made this dress, and I also got something else out of it as well. I'm not sure whether I made an Ogden cami. Can't quite remember, but anyway, yeah, I've dragged this out from under the bed from my, I need to get all my summer clothes out actually and go through those. And yeah, dragged this out and decided to put this on today because it's just a real nice, simple dress that's fairly cool to wear in this hot weather that we're having at the minute. So anyway, moving on, we'll start by showing you my pattern. The first one that I picked up was McCall's M7892, which is this one here. And this is a pattern for woven fabrics, and it recommends fabrics such as crepe, georgette, crepe de chine, and cotton blends as well. You've obviously got different options here. You can go for the little wrap top, one with a bit of a peplum, or you can go for the dress with either a wraparound with a bit of a sort of high-low hem thing going on there. You'll have to excuse my nails. I wanted to get them done actually before I vlogged this afternoon, because doing all that housework has chipped them. But anyway, yeah, so yeah, you've got different sleeve options as well. You've got a bit more of a sort of bell sleeve, is it, with some gathering around the cuff there, or you've also got the options, which is on the model, which is just like a fluted trumpet sleeve, I guess, as well. And yeah, it takes between 1.5 and 4.5 meters of fabric, dependent on your fabric choices and obviously what size you make, etc. But I thought that was really pretty. I think I quite like I quite like this version here, but probably with just the normal, the sort of gathered sleeve around the cuff rather than the trumpet sleeve. I think the trumpet sleeve might be a little bit too much, but yeah, I really thought that was quite pretty. And the wrap style tends to sort of suit my figure a little bit, so looking forward to having a go at that one. This one I picked up was this one, which is McCalls M7803. So that's this one here. So again, we've got the option of a top or a dress with a bit of a peplum that you can have over the dress, and it's got a tie front and different sleeve options as well. You've got three sleeve options here. You've got, like, it looks like a fluted sleeve. There's also a little cap fluted sleeve, and again, you've got the trumpet fluted sleeve. Again, this is a pattern for woven fabrics, but it also says that you can use stable knits as well, so that'll be things such as interlocks and scubas, I would have thought, although scuba might be a bit heavy. You could maybe go for a scuba crepe, I guess, and Ponte Roma as well would work really well. Now, I like this option here. I think that's really nice. Yeah, I think I'd probably make this out of maybe a viscose, which is a chalet, isn't it? Right, rayon, that type of thing. I'd probably make it out of that. Just want to say, actually, I've got my door to the garden, which is directly behind the camera, open at the minute, and I'm not sure if you can hear the noise from outside. There's the birds tweeting like mad in the garden, and then far, far beyond that, there is a bit of the noise of the motorway. Where I live, quite often you don't hear the motorway, but it just depends which way the wind's blowing. If the wind's blowing sort of this way towards me, then you will hear a bit of the motorway. So I'm really sorry if you can hear that in the background, but I really don't want to shut the doors because it's just, I'm just going to melt otherwise. So I'm really sorry about that, and hope that you can hear me okay. So yeah, again, this pattern takes between 1.5 and 3 meters of fabric, dependent on which version that you're going to make. But yeah, I thought that was really nice. I do like the tie front detail. I think that's nice for my kind of figure, where you want in to sort of emphasize your smallest part, which in my case is my waist. So yeah, really, really like that one. Next one I picked up is, if you are on Instagram, you will have heard about one of the sewing challenges that has just been launched again this last couple of weeks, which is the Sew Together for Summer challenge. And this is run by Rocco Siena, Sewing in Spain, and oh gosh, I can't remember the other lady. I will put it down below if I can remember who it is. But basically, they run this challenge every year, and it changes every year. So last year, I think it was, I don't know, summer dresses, something like that. This year it's jumpsuits. It's all about the jumpsuit. I've made a couple of jumpsuits already. I did give a sneaky peek on my Instagram stories a couple of days ago of the Joni jumpsuit by Friday Pattern Company that I have made this week. I've made that up in a grape purple Ponte Roma. I did it as a toile, to be honest, because I've bought some really nice gorgeous modal jersey from System Intarka, that's it. I'll put a little picture of that in here so that you can see what that looks like. And I can't actually show you the jumpsuit today because it's hung on my washing line at the minute, because I've just washed it this morning. But I'll probably show you that in my next vlog and give you a bit of a pattern review on that. Really happy with it. I feel quite nice in it, actually, especially with losing a little bit of weight. So I feel quite confident in it now. So it's not something I would have worn when I was a little bit bigger. But yeah, I'm looking forward to making that. So yes, getting back on track, it's all about the jumpsuit this summer, and there are tons of jumpsuit patterns out there. And one of the ones that seems to be quite popular in ready to wear at the minute, and I've seen a few popping up on Instagram as well, is the sort of classic boiler suit type jumpsuit. Now, I'm not actually totally sure that that's my kind of style, but I picked this pattern up from McCall's, which is M7330. And I don't think I would ever make this, I'll be perfectly honest, but I actually liked the shorter versions, these three. I think these are all really quite nice. because they've got more of a fitted silhouette, and I just think they're really lovely, to be honest. Again, this is a pattern for woven fabrics, but it recommends that you can use cottons, but you can also use washed silks and viscose challis as well. So you can use the drapey fabrics as well as something a little bit more substantial. Okay, number four is not a seasonally appropriate pattern, but I did pick it up anyway because this is a pattern that I have wanted for some time. It's McCalls M6800 and it's this gorgeous, gorgeous coat pattern. I love this. I think it's beautiful. I think it's really flattering, and I would just, yeah, love to make a coat this particular version here. So this is described as a fitted and flared lined coat with collar variations, seam detail, side or side front pockets, two-piece sleeves with a shaped hemline where the lining shows. It's got a detachable lined collar, carrier's belt, and one of the versions has a detachable hood as well. So there's lots of options with this. Yeah, really pretty. I think they're all really nice, actually. I like this little green one. I think that's very sort of military style. And of course, I'm not going to be making this time of year when we're heading into summer and the weather is like it is at the minute. But certainly towards the end of the year, this is definitely a pattern that might be on my make list. So watch out for that one. Final one that I have to show you, and the envelope is very battered because this is the one that I have made up that I'm going to show you the finished article, is McCall's M7889, and it's this one here. So this is a pattern from their early spring collection, and it's basically a non-collared button-up dress with a yoke, pleats in, or you can make it into a top as well. There is a top version there, but it has pleats in the front and pleats in the back. You've got a version here, I think that's the one, no, it's this one here, that's got like a little tie around the neck detail there. It's got front and back yoke, different sleeves, and it's got the option on this one here of doing a bit of colour blocking there or stripe alteration or whatever. And yeah, this is again designed for woven fabrics, so it recommends fabrics such as poplin, gingham, cotton blends, A, C and D, not beef bizarrely, I don't know why. It also says you can use sateen, so that's like a fabric that's got a bit of stretch in. Now it does say that this is a very loose fitting, garments. And yeah, it really, really is. I've made this and I decided to make View B, which is this one here. Last year I bought some gorgeous cotton linen, striped cotton linen in blue and white from Walton's Fabrics, which is my local fabric store. And I decided that I wanted to play around with the stripes on that to get sort of a chevron effect. And I really liked this and thought it would make a really lovely summer dress. So that's what I've made. I will show you that in a minute when I've told you a little bit more about this pattern. Basically, as I mentioned earlier about McCall's new pattern seems to be putting their finished garment measurements actually on the reverse of the envelope. They have done here, and it's really quite shocking when I looked at this, I'll be perfectly honest. Now, I am normally I would say round about a size 12 at the minute. My full bust is a 36 inch bust, which obviously in ready to wear is round about the 12 to 14 mark. In patterns, normally in the big four patterns, you're usually looking at that, I think maybe the 14 to 16. However, this one, the finished garment measurements of a size 12, if I can just show you this here, is there, I don't know if you can see that, but it says 44 and a half inches. So bearing in mind that my full bust is 36 inches, that's 8.5 inches of ease. Now, there is no way that I wanted that amount of ease around my bust in a cotton linen fabric. I just thought that's just gonna be massive. The hip measurement of the finished garment in the size 12 is 54 inches. My hips are 43 at the minute. Now, bearing in mind it is obviously a, you know, it's a loose fit skirt. Before I actually made this, I decided to have a little think about how much ease I did want in this dress and which size I was going to do. Now, looking at the size 6, which is the smallest size, I've never been a size 6. I don't think I was a size 6 when I was born. But the finished measurement of the bust in a size 6 is actually 41 inches and the hip is 50.5 inches. So, bearing in mind that I'm a 36 full bust, that would still have given me 5 inches of ease. I still didn't feel comfortable making a size 6, and the reason for that was because of the yoke at the back. I just show you the line drawings. I don't know if you can see the yoke at the back there, and I do have quite a broad back, and I was really worried that if I made the size 6, although the full bust might fit me okay, that the yoke bit across the shoulders would just be far too small. So I actually went for the size 10. I traced off the size 10. I thought let's just sort of go in between, and it's worked out really, really perfectly. So let me show you the dress. So this is the dress here, and I am super happy with this dress. I think it's gorgeous. It's perfect for this kind of weather. So what you've got is you have a faced neckline, and it's the yoke is, if I can just undo this actually and show you better, the yoke is fully enclosed inside. I don't know if you can see that there. So it's really nice and neat. Now you'll notice the faced front bit of the collar there, I've actually had to use my pinking shears on that. And that's because one of the things that always bothers me with commercial patterns is they don't always tell you when to finish the seams or whatever. So I didn't take the cue from that, because this neckline facing is actually constructed in quite an unusual way, so that you get the fully enclosed yoke inside and the facing is attached round the front neckline. So I didn't actually pick up on the fact that actually I should have finished those front piece, those facing pieces for the front neckline. I should have actually finished those before I attached it to the back yoke, the internal back yoke. Does that make sense? Because I don't feel like I'm explaining this very well at all. But anyway, once I'd stitched that together, and then I realised actually now I'm going to be attaching this to the outer dress, I needed to have finished that off, overlocked it or whatever, and I didn't do. So I've had to just go around that with my pinking shears, and I'm hoping that that will be okay. But it's got a button front placket, as you can see. There is understitching. I've understitched, yes, it does tell you to understitch around the neckline, so that obviously fits in nice and flat. You've also got these little front yoke pieces as well, which you cut on the bias for this particular version, which again is version B. And I think that's quite nice. I like how those stripes match there as well. The pleats in the waistline, if I just show you those, bring them in a bit closer. Basically they're pinch pleats, so you pinch the garment together and then pin it in three places, both sides of the waist, and then you sew a line of stitches across. Now, yeah, I know that that looks really not very neat at all at the minute, but you have a belt to cover that, so you don't have to worry too much about that. Now, the back is, obviously you've got the yoke across the back as well. And then you have the pleats again in the back, if you can see that there. Now, the only thing where I veered from the pattern instructions with this bit was it told you to stitch all the way across the back, and I didn't do that. I just replicated what you do at the front, where I just stitched across the actual pleats. I didn't understand why it told you to do that, but anyway. But the best bit that I like about this dress is the, if I just hang it over my shoulder, I can show you the bottom, is the bottom band here, which is just lovely. I played about with pattern placement on the fabric so that I could get these the chevron at the bottom like that, and it's double faced, so you've got no hem at the bottom because you actually attach it to the inside of the dress. And if I just show you the inside of the dress, where you attach it, I have used some neutral satin bias binding all the way around to hide that seam there, and I'm really pleased with how that's come out. It also means it gives you a bit of structure to the bottom of the dress, so it hangs really nicely as well. The back at the bottom of the dress is also the same, so there you can see, and look at my pattern matching there with those chevrons. I'm super happy with how that's come out. Now this back piece is actually one piece that's cut on the fold, but I knew that with my striped fabric that that wouldn't work, because I would just get the stripes all going in one direction, and I wanted to create that chevron effect in the middle of the back at the bottom, so that it just looked better. And so what I did was, I instead of cutting that piece on the fold, I cut two pieces but added on a 5/8 inch seam allowance onto both pieces of fabric so that I could join them together, and then it would all fit. So I'm super happy with how that looks. My stripe matching at the side is also pretty spot on. That's one side and the other side. This is the first time I've ever done anything like this, where I've created chevrons, and it was actually easier than I expected it to be perfectly honest. And then finally you just create a little belt, which obviously it gives you instructions for, and then that ties around the middle. So I will put this on and put some little pictures in of me wearing it so that you can have a look and see what you think. Okay, so that's it from me today, and yeah, I hope you like the dress that I made. I really wanted to get that dress made up. This evening, me and my husband are going out with my brother and my sister-in-law. They live in York. I don't know if you can see how hot I am at the minute, because I am starting to totally melt. It's just so warm. Yes, we're going out this evening with my brother and sister-in-law for a few drinks in the sun. They live at York, and yeah, it's lovely to have a little walk along the river in an evening. So we're going to do that this evening, and I'm going to wear my new dress, so I can't wait for that. I hope whatever you're doing, you're enjoying your Sunday. Obviously, if you do celebrate Easter, then happy Easter. If you don't celebrate Easter, then I just hope you, wherever you are, you're having a lovely, lovely Sunday afternoon. And yeah, I'm hoping to be back later on during the week to show you my Friday Pattern Company Joanie jumpsuit. That's the only other thing I've made this week. And as if that isn't enough. But yeah, whatever you're doing, have fun, and I'll be back with you really soon. Take care, guys. Bye.